you see this picture, each one of you, so you can see earlier people, what I said is, earlier people used to think that Earth is spherical in shape, but this is not a perfect sphere. As you can see, there is, this Earth is flattened at the poles. This area is called the poles, okay? So it is flattened at the poles and you can see a small bulge, okay, at the center. So here is the equator, 0 degrees. So there is a bulge at the equator and Earth is flattened at the poles. We say that the shape of the Earth is geoid shape. Geoid ka matlab, the shape is Earth-like shape. That means Earth has a unique shape. It is not perfectly spherical, okay, in the real sense. The shape of Earth is unique. It is flattened at the poles. Therefore, this shape is called the Earth-like shape. Now, the next point is Earth is a unique planet. Why it is a unique planet? Because there is air. Air means the oxygen that we breathe in, which is important for life. It is there. Then the second necessity, water is there. Okay. And third thing is it is neither too hot nor too cold. Okay. So the climate is such that human beings can survive. So all the conditions are favorable for life on Earth. To the Moon. Now, Moon, everyone must be knowing that it is the satellite of Earth. The natural satellite of Earth is Moon, which is shown here in the diagram. Okay. And a circle is shown. Circle means this is the path of the Moon. So, Moon, it revolves around the Earth. So, it is the satellite of planet Earth. So, Earth has just one satellite, which is the Moon. Okay. And here is the definition of satellite. It is a celestial body. Celestial move around the planets in the same way as planets move around the sun. So I have told you that Moon is a satellite. Why? Because it revolves around the Earth in the same way Earth revolves around the sun. The Moon, it revolves around the Earth in about 27 days. Okay. So what happens is Moon is revolving around the Earth in this path. Okay. And it is also rotating on its axis. That the Moon's revolution time and rotation time is same, which is around 27 days. So that means we can only see one side of the Moon. Okay, the asteroids. Now, I am discussing asteroids, although these are very general things, but you should know what is the difference between asteroids and meteoroids. So as you can see in the universe, there are stars, there are planets, there are satellites. See, okay, apart from it, in the solar system, there are many tiny bodies that also move around the sun. So these tiny bodies are called asteroids. So asteroids is basically, these are the rocky bodies. As you can see in this picture, it is made up of rock. And they also revolve around the sun. So they orbit the sun. So asteroids, they are smaller than a planet, but they are larger than a small stone-like object, which is known as meteoroid. So asteroid belt. So where is this belt? Basically between Mars and Jupiter, the two planets, between these two planets, you will find most of the asteroids, these purple thing. Most of the asteroids are located between two planets that you should know. These are Mars and Jupiter. These asteroids can also hang out in other locations around the solar system. So some of the asteroids you can also find near the Earth, but generally this is the belt, okay? Between Mars and Jupiter, this is the belt where most of the asteroids are found. So this is known as asteroid belt. Now meteoroids. Now this meteoroids. Now why I'm discussing it is because you should know the difference between asteroid and meteoroid. Now meteoroid, as you can see in this picture, it is a piece of asteroid. So if a small piece breaks from asteroid, it is known as meteoroid. Okay. So as it is written, sometimes an asteroid can smash into another. There may be collision of two asteroids. And this can cause small pieces of asteroid to break off. So these are called meteoroids. Now we will talk about what are meteors. Now at times what happened is that a meteoroid means a small piece of asteroid, it comes so close to Earth that when it enters the Earth atmosphere, while entering the Earth, what happens? It vaporizes. Vaporizes means it burns. And it turns into a meteor. Meteor means it started burning, and you can see it like a light here, like the shooting star. You call it sometime shooting star. Okay. But meteors are not actually stars. So what happened? When a meteorite, it comes so closer to Earth that it enters the Earth atmosphere. And while entering the Earth atmosphere, it starts to burn. It vaporizes. And so you can see in the sky, there is a line or there is light. Okay, a line of light. So this is known as meteor. Now, what are meteorites? Okay, R-I-T-E-S. These are basically what happens when a piece, or you can say when meteoroid, when they enter the Earth's surface, but they don't burn completely at times, okay? So they don't vaporize completely and they fall on Earth like a rock here, as it is shown in the picture, okay? So they don't vaporize completely. They survive their trip through Earth's atmosphere and land on Earth's surface, okay? So when in the form of this piece of stone, when they land on the surface of Earth, okay, because they are not able to burn completely, then those meteoroids are known as meteoroids. The last thing is comets. Okay, so you know there are 8 planets that you can study if you have class 6th NCERT of geography. So there is a first chapter, which is a very basic one that you can go through, that there are 8 planets. Now, comets are what? Asteroid, I told you, they were rocky. They were rock, basically. But comets, they orbit the sun, but they are made of ice and dust. They are not rocks. Okay. They also move around the sun, but they are not made up of rock. They are basically ice and dust. Okay. So when they take orbit, that means when they revolve around the sun, they begin to vaporize, and then at times you can see the comet's tail like this. This is the tail of the comet. Okay. So the difference between asteroid and comet is that comet is made up of ice and dust. Okay. And asteroids are made up of rock. So these are the 8 planets in the solar system. Okay. You must know their name and the order: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars. This we know from childhood. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune.